Students of Dairy Science is awarded two medals. Arif Sharma, gold medal for securing highest OGPA in the Dairy Chemistry and Amul medal in the same subject. Srimati V.S. Sirapurappu Memorial Gold Medal is awarded to Shah Nikunj Ashok Kumar for securing maximum OGPA in M.Tech SPT examination. Sri K.K. Shukla Medal is awarded to Patel Ketan Kumar Ramesh Bhai for best PG research in the Veterinary Science and Animal Husbandry. JVTR Health Limited Medal is awarded to Banupriya Goyal for securing highest OGPA in MBA IIT. Medalist for the Faculty of Agriculture, Ramjilal Yadav, the students of BSA awarded three medals. Vice Chancellor Gold Medal, three. Dr. Ranchorbhai M. Gold Medal for Plant Breeding and Genetic Subject. Dr. Ramjimai M. Patel Medal for securing highest OGPA in the Agriculture Strategy. Jani Bhavin Kumar Narayan Bhai is awarded nine medals and one case prize. Dr. B.V. Mehta Medal, Dr. Minal Kanti Chakravarti Medal, Sri Jaswai J. Patel Medal, Dr. J.D. Patel Medal, Dr. Rauji Bhai C. Patel Medal, Sri Harikaka Medal, Sri Suresh Bhai N. Patel Medal, Sri Daya Bhai Ambalal Patel, Gujarat State First Batch Agricultural Graduate Gold Medal and American Spring Pressing Limited Cash Prize. Jinsi Matthew, student of BSEA, awarded two medals and one cash prize. Dr. M.V. Desai Medal, Dr. H.N. Patel Medal and Naman Trust M.D. Patel Cash Prize. Dr. P.D. Mistry Medal is awarded to Sital Raj Sharma for securing highest OGPA in the subject of agriculture meteorology and related courses. The Satyendra Y.K. Patel Dabhau Gold Medal is awarded to M. Abhinaya for securing highest OGPA in the subject of economics. Sri Bahubai Jasbhai Patel Shasti Purti Spurti Gold Medal is awarded to Bogra Mayam Chandubhai for securing highest OGPA in subject of agronomy. Now for the veterinary science, Jar Ramesh Kumar, student of veterinary, awarded nine medals and one test prize. Vice Chancellor Medal, Dr. R.K. Shukla Medal, Dr. J.C. S.G.C. Medal, S.J.C. Medal for clinical subject, M.R. Varia Medal, D.C. Desai Charity Medal, Sri Hemabendi OST Medal, ISPT Anand Medal, Postpac Poultry and Cattle Feed Medal, and D.P. Pandya Cash Prize. Godasra Priya Dinesh Bhai awarded medal for Shailesh Bhai Ramesh Bhai Patel Shakti Group Sarsa Gold Medal, then Mehman Trust T.N. Vaishnav Cash Prize. Dr. M.N. Mansuri Gold Medal is awarded to Labana Yanini Chakravarti for securing, he is not able to attend because of these phenomenal circumstances. Dr. A.D. Patel Medal is awarded to Chaudhary Sanjaya Abhiraj for securing highest GP in the LPM subject. Mehman Trust Dr. N.C. Patel, N.C. Bhuj Cash Prize is awarded to Kothambi Urja Yogin Bhai. He is also absent. Medalist for the Faculty of Dairy Science. Chikura Sylvia Jerome, students of PET MC College of Dairy Science, is awarded 15 medals and 2 case prizes. Vice Chancellor Gold Medal, G.V. Patel Medal, State Mansuklal C. Desai Medal, State Mansuklal C. Desai Medal for Microbiology, for Dairy Chemistry, for Dairy Engineering, for Dairy Technology, ISO GPA in D.Tech D.T. examination, again Kapila Ben for Dairy Engineering. Dairy Engineering again for Sanskara Medal, Kanu Bhai Chhota Bhai Medal for Dairy Technology, Shrestha Milk Gandhi Gavriwala Medal for Dairy Technology, Sri Indu Bhai R. Patel Medal for Dairy Microbiology, D.Tech D.T. 1995 Medal, Sri R.J. Patel Medal, Mehman Trust D.N. Patel Medal, Mehman Trust B. Kurian Medal for Cash Prize. Now the medalist for the Food Processing Technology, Abhilasha, students of FPT, is awarded two medals and one case prize. Vice Chancellor Gold Medal, Professor S.C. Bose Sirpur Gold Medal, and Mehman Trust Dr. K.M. Munshi Cash Prize. Medalist for Faculty of Agriculture Engineering, Vivek Tripathi, students of AET Godhra awarded two medals, vice chancellor gold medal and Sri Venkata Subbaiya Sirapuku medal for highest LGPA. Panelist for Agriculture Information Technology, Vice Chancellor Gold Medal is awarded to Swapnil Prakash for achieving highest ODTA. Thank you, Madam.
We have a Manash Shri Govind Bhai Patel, Honorable Minister of State for Agriculture, as our honorable guest of honor. We believe that all labor that uplifts humanity has dignity and importance and should be undertaken with painstaking excellence. I request him to kindly address the gathering, please.
Anand Agriculture University na dasma padvidan samaramma apni vache upasthit apna rajya na mahamahim rajyapal adarniya Shri Kamla ji apna desh nu gaurav missile man purva rashtrapati ane aajna aa function ma chief guest tarike उपस्थित एवं डॉक्टर अबुल कलाम जी अपना यूनिवर्सिटी ना वाइस चांसलर श्री रजिस्ट्रार श्री गुजरात में विविध कृषि यूनिवर्सिटी ना वाइस चांसलर श्री विविध फैकल्टी ना वैज्ञानिक मित्रों तज्ञों प्रोफेसरों विद्यार्थी मित्रों पत्रकार मित्रों भाइयों ने बहनों आज आ दसवां पदवीदान समारंभ में अपनी वच्चे उपस्थित रहेवानो मने जे सद्भाग्य सांपड़ो छे अने मारी जात ने हूँ गौरव अनुभवुं छुं अहीं मित्रों पदवी लेवानी से स्नातक अनुस्नातक ने पदवी लईने ए फील्ड नी अंदर जारे जवाना से त्यारे अहींथी तेमने ज्ञान प्राप्त थयुं छे यूनिवर्सिटी द्वारा मित्रों एक एवा प्रकारना फील्ड में तमे ने हूँ काम करी रह्या छे के जे फील्ड में एक जबरदस्त ऑपोर्चुनिटी पड़े छे अनेक पड़कारों से पर पड़कारों का सामना करवाने की क्षमता ने शक्ति आपरा सब में पड़ी जहां पड़कारों हो त्या ऑपर्चुनिटी पण होय छे अने एक एवं क्षेत्र से कृषि क्षेत्र आज दुनिया ना अनेक देशों अनेक प्रकार ना संशोधनों करीने उपग्रह सुधी पहुंचा से यान लेने ऊपर सुधी पहुंचा से पर अने दुनिया ने एक पर लेबोरेटरी ये भी नहीं थई कि जे लेबोरेटरी में मानस ने के पशुओं ने खावा बाटी ने कोई चीज पैदा करती हुई मित्रों आ वस्तु मात्र ने मात्र खेती अने कृषि द्वारा शक्य थे अने क्षेत्र में आपने सौए काम करवाना अने देश नी एक अपनी गणना पात्र गणाय के भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश छे पर कमनसीबे आपनी रही छे आज दिवस सुधी केवाड़ो कृषि प्रधान देश पर कृषि प्रत्येनो जे लक्ष्य आपण होतो ए थी जे आपे दिशा बदली ए दिशा में आपे ध्यान आयतु नहीं परिणाम अपने आईपीएल नीचे अमेरिका से कैनाडा से घऊ मंगावा पड़ता है परिस्थिति आ देश की सर्जा ने कुदरते आ देश में अनेक प्रकार की समृद्धि आपी है जमीन आपी है पानी आप हवामान सारू है पर कमनसीब ये रही के दिशा में आपने काम करता दिशा स्वीकार थी जेना कारण आपने क्या ने क्या भटकव पड़ो मित्रों अनेक क्षेत्र की अंदर जे आज मने कहता आनंद थाय के गुजराते छेला 10 वर्ष की अंदर कृषि क्षेत्र में जे प्रकारे प्रयासों कर्या छे आज दिवस सुधी एम कहवा तो भटकाणी आप एक कहवत है कि उत्तम खेती मध्यम व्यापार ने कनिष्ठ नौकरी पर कमनसीब ये रही कि उत्तम कहवाती खेती कनिष्ठ बनी અને કનિષ્ઠ કહેવાતી નોકરી એ ઉત્તમ બની ચાર દિવસ સુધી સિલસિલો આપણો વચર્યો છે આજે ફરીવાર આપણે દિવસો જોઈ રહ્યા છે જમીન છે જમીન લાંબી થવાની નથી વધવાની નથી પોપ્યુલેશન આપણું વધતું જાય અને વધતા જતા પોપ્યુલેશનને જીવન જરૂરિયાતની જે વસ્તુઓ છે એ વસ્તુ માત્ર ને માત્ર જમીનમાંથી પેદા થવાની છે અને આપણા સંસદનો દ્વારા એમાં મદદરૂપ થવાનું મિત્રો જે પ્રકારે આજે વિદેશી પડકારો આપણી સામે છે ઇઝરાયલ જેવો નાનકડો એક ખોબા જેવડો દેશ દુનિયાભરમાં વિખાયેલો પીખાયેલો અને જ્યારે બે ઇઝરાયલીઓ મળે નવા વર્ષમાં જેમ આપણે શુભકામના આપવા માટે મળીએ ત્યારે એ ઇઝરાયલીઓ કહેતા નેક્સ્ટ યર વી વિલ મીટ ટુ જેરુસલેમ મિત્રો એની હિબ્રુ ભાષા ભૂલા નહીં ઇઝરાયલનો એનું પાટનગર ભૂલા નહીં અને જ્યારે ઇઝરાયલ આઝાદ થયો આપણે આજે જોઈ છે એક ખોબા જેવડો નાનકડો દેશ ચારે બાજુથી દુશ્મનોથી ઘેરાયેલો દેશ જ્યાં જમીન વરસાદનું પાણી માત્ર 3-4 ઇંચ પડે છે રણ પ્રદેશ છે ખેતી લાયક જમીન પણ નથી અને છતાં ઇઝરાયલ આખા દુનિયાને ટેકનોલોજી ખેતીની પૂરી પાડતો દેશ આજે ઇઝરાયલ બીનો કારણ રાષ્ટ્ર પ્રત્યે એક ભાવના કે મારે કંઈક કરવું છે કેન આઈ ડુ નહીં પ્રશ્નાર્થી નહીં આઈ વિલ ડુ હું કરીશ આ સ્પિરિટ સાથે એ દેશના નાગરિકો આગળ વધ્યા આજે આપણે જોઈશું કે કેવા તો આ ભારત દેશ કૃષિ પ્રધાન અને ખેતીવાડી ક્ષેત્રની આધુનિક ટેકનિક પદ્ધતિ શીખવા માટે એની લેવા માટે આજે ઇઝરાયલથી આપણે આયાત કરવી પડે મિત્રો આ દિશામાં આપણે વિચાર કરવાનો છે એના માટે ચિંતન કરવાનું આપણા માટે ગંભીર સમસ્યા કે આવડો મોટો દેશ 120 કરોડનો આટલી મોટી આપણી પાસે જમીન છે પાણી છે સાધનો છે અને છતાં આપણે બીજા પર પરાવલંબન કેમ રહેવું પડે આજે જે પ્રકારના બિયારણો આપણે ત્યાં આવે છે મને વાતની ચિંતા છે મેં મારા 3-3 યુનિવર્સિટીના વિષય સાથે બાબતની ચર્ચા પણ કરી આજે બજારની અંદર તમે જોશો તો તરબૂચ તમને 12 માસ મળશે કે તરબૂચ ક્યાંના છે કાં તો ચાઇના હોય કે તો તાઇવાનના એ બિયારણ તાઇવાન અને ચાઇનાનો અને 5-7 વર્ષ પછી આજે હું જોઉં છું કે આપણા ઓરિજિનલ તરબૂચ આપણી આ નદીમાં વાત્રક નદીમાં થતા તરબૂચ આજે એનું બિયારણ શોધવું મુશ્કેલ છે આવતા દિવસોમાં આ તાઇવાન અને એમ કહેશે ચીન એમ કહેશે કે અમારે આ તરબૂચના બીજ 1 લાખ રૂપિયા કિલો વેચવા આપણે પે કરવા પડશે કારણ કે આપણી પાસે આપણી ઓરિજિનલ બિયારણ નથી આજે કમેટી છે મરચી છે બકાલા ક્ષેત્રની અંદર હમણાં ચર્ચા કરતો હતો સવારે કે અનેક પ્રકારના સંશોધનની આવશ્યકતા ક્ષેત્રમાં પડી શાકભાજી ક્ષેત્રની અંદર જે બિયારણો આવે છે આજે ખેડૂતો વાવે છે નો ડાઉટ ઉત્પાદન વધુ સારું થાય છે પણ 2-4 વર્ષ 5 વર્ષ પછી એની મૂળભૂત જે બિયારણ એની પાસે હશે પછી એ મરચી હશે ટમેટી હશે રીંગણ હશે એ બિયારણ એની પાસે મૂળભૂત બિયારણ નહીં હોય એને પરાવલંબી પેલા જે સપ્લાયર એની પાસે રહેવું પડશે અને એ ભાવ જે માંગશે ભાવ આપણે આપવો પડશે. તો મિત્રો, આપણા વૈજ્ઞાનિકો, આપણા સંશોધકો આપણા ફાર્મ ઉપર આ બિયારણમાં આપણું જે ઓરિજિનલ બિયારણ છે એમાં સંશોધન કરીને એમાં વધુ ઉત્પાદન ખેડૂતો મેળવે, પોષણક્ષમ ભાવ મેળવી શકે, વધુ ઉત્પાદન કરી શકે એ પ્રકારની ટેકનિક આપણે કેમ ન વિકસાવી. મેં મારા તળે તળ વિશે કીધું કે દુનિયાની કોઈ પણ દેશની ટેકનોલોજી તમારે લાવવી હોય તો લાવો, ઇઝરાયલની ગમે તો ઇઝરાયલ, ચાઇનાની તો ચાઇના, તાઇવાનની તો તાઇવાનની, આપણા ફિલ્ડ ઉપર એને કામ કરાવો, આપણા સાયન્ટિસ્ટો સાથે કામ કરાવો. એમાં જે કઈ ખર્ચ થશે રાજ્ય સરકાર પે કરવા તૈયાર, પણ આપણા સાયન્ટિસ્ટો સાથે કામ કરે, આપણા ફાર્મર સાથે કામ કરે, આપણા ફિલ્ડ ઉપર કામ કરે, અને આવતા 3-4 વર્ષમાં આપણો ખેડૂત, આપણો સાયન્ટિસ્ટ, આપણી લેબ એ દિશામાં કાર્યાન્વિત થાય, ઉત્પાદન કરતી થાય. આજે જે વિદેશમાંથી આપણે બિયારણ મંગાવવું પડે એ બિયારણનું હબ આપણે કેમ ન બનીએ, એ સંશોધનના કેન્દ્ર આપણે કેમ ન કરીએ. આજે આપણી યુનિવર્સિટી, આપણું બીજ નિગમ, એનું બજારમાં માંગ છે, એ બીજ નિગમના નામથી લોકો માલ ખરીદે છે. તો બીજ નિગમને વાઇટ સ્કેલ ઉપર શું કામ ન થઈ જઈએ. એ બીજ નિગમમાં ખેડૂતના ફાર્મ સુધી આપણો સાયન્ટિસ્ટ જાય, એને મદદગારી કરે, એને માર્ગદર્શન આપે, સીડ વિલેજ બને, અને સીડ વિલેજ બનાવીને એ ઉત્પાદન આપણે કૃષિને કરાવીએ તો આપણો ખેડૂત સમૃદ્ધ થશે, આપણી ખેતી સમૃદ્ધ થશે, અને આવતા દિવસોમાં આપણે આ દિશામાં કામ કરવાનું છે. મિત્રો, તમે જે કઈ અહીંથી જ્ઞાન પ્રાપ્ત કર્યું એ માત્ર તમારા તમારા કુટુંબ પૂરતું સીમિત નહીં રાખતા, વાઇડ સ્કેલની અંદર એનો ઉપયોગ થાય, વધુમાં વધુ ખેડૂતને એનું તમારા જ્ઞાનનો લાભ મળે, તમારી તકનીકીનો લાભ મળે. જે પ્રકારે આજે ટેકનોલોજી આવી રહી, મશીનરી ટેકનોલોજી આવી રહી, મેં જોયું છે આજથી 10 વર્ષ પહેલા આપણી કપાસની સાખીઓ કાઢીને લોકો ખેડૂતો મારી નાખતા, આજે હાર્વેસ્ટર આવ્યા, રોટાવેટર આવ્યા, એ રોટાવેટરથી એ સાખી કટિંગ થઈને ખાતરના સ્વરૂપમાં પાછી જમીનમાં જાય, જે સાખીના થડની અંદર, છોડની અંદર 30-40% ખાતર પીડ્યું છે, જેનો સ્ટોર પીડ્યો છે એ સ્ટોર ફરીથી આ જમીનની અંદર જાય, જમીન ફળદ્રુપ બને. મિત્રો, ધીરે ધીરે આ ટેકનિક બધા આપણે લઈ જવાની, આપણે ખેડૂતને દિશામાં દોરવાનો, અને એક વખત ખેડૂત આ દિશામાં કામ કરશે. અને સૌથી મહત્વની વાત કે આજે ઓર્ગેનિક ફાર્મિંગની એક જબરદસ્ત માંગ દુનિયાભરના લોકોને, આજે જે પ્રકારે જમીનની અંદર આપણે રાસાયણિક ખાતરો, જંતુનાશક દવાઓ નાખીને આપણા ઉત્પાદનોને ઝેરી બનાવ્યા, જમીનનું તળ પણ ઝેરી બન્યું છે, એમાંથી બહાર કાઢવા માટે દુનિયાના દેશો આજે આ ચીજ લેવા માટે તૈયાર નથી. પણ ઓર્ગેનિક પદ્ધતિથી ઉત્પાદિત કરેલો કૃષિનો કોઈ પણ માલ, પછી તલ હોય, મગફળી હોય, શાકભાજી હોય, કોઈ ભાવ પૂછતો નથી, લાઈનમાં ઉભો રહીને ગ્રાહક લેવા તૈયાર છે. મિત્રો, એ દિશામાં આપણે આપણા ખેડૂતોને દોરી જઈને આપણી શક્તિનો, કુદરતે આપણે જે શક્તિ આપી છે, આપણે યુનિવર્સિટી જે કરીથી જ્ઞાન પ્રાપ્ત થયું છે, એ જ્ઞાનને ખેડૂતોની વચ્ચે આપણે સૌ શેર કરીએ, અને તમે અને હું આપણે સૌ સાથે મળીને આવતા દિવસોમાં ગુજરાત જે આજે છેલ્લા 10 વર્ષથી સમગ્ર દેશની અંદર કૃષિ વિકાસ દરની અંદર જે 10.6% એવરેજ 9% દર આખા દેશમાં હાઈએસ્ટ દર આપણો છે, દેશ આજે 2.5%માંથી 3% જીડીપીના દર લઈ જવા માટેનો પ્રયાસ કરે ત્યારે આપણે એવરેજ 9% પહોંચ્યા છીએ. મિત્રો, આ 9-11% કેમ જાય એનો પ્રયાસ આજે રાજ્ય સરકાર કરે, આપણે સૌ એ દિશામાં પણ કાર્યાન્વિત થઈએ. ફરીથી આપ સૌને, જેમને કોઈને 1 ચંદ્રક મળ્યો છે, કોઈને 15 મળ્યા છે, કોઈને 17 મળ્યા, 9 મળ્યા, 7 મળ્યા, આ બધા પદકો મેળવનાર વિદ્યાર્થી ભાઈઓ અને બહેનોને પણ મારા વતી અને રાજ્ય સરકાર વતી ખૂબ ખૂબ અભિનંદન અને ધન્યવાદ આપું છું. आज जे किसी पदवी प्राप्त करीने जनार विद्यार्थी भाई और बहनों से એમને મારા વતી અને રાજ્ય સરકાર વતી શુભકામના પાઠવું છું કે આવતા દિવસોમાં આવનારા કોઈ પણ પ્રકારના પડકારનો સામનો કરવા માટે આપણા માનનીય મુખ્યમંત્રી જે પ્રમાણે કહે છે ને કે સ્વપ્ન હંમેશા ઊંચું જુઓ અને સ્વપ્ન માત્ર દિવસનું જુઓ અને જે સ્વપ્ન આપણે જોઈએ છીએ એ સ્વપ્નને સાકાર કરવાની દિશામાં પ્રયત્ન કરો તો મને લાગે છે કે આવતા દિવસોમાં માનનીય મુખ્યમંત્રી શ્રી નરેન્દ્રભાઈ મોદી જે પ્રકારે આ જે ગુજરાત ને જે પ્રકારે દેશ ને દોરવા જઈ રહ્યા છે તે દિશામાં આપણે બધા સહભાગી થઈએ એવી ખૂબ ભાવના સાથે મારી વાત શરૂ કરું છું. તેનો આભાર ધન્યવાદ. જય શ્રી ગણેશ.
Courage in adversity, patience in prosperity, oratory in assembly, bravery in battle, attachment to knowledge, all these are naturally found in great personalities.
It is a singular honor and rare privilege to have amongst us a distinguished man, a scholar, a scientist, leader of India's space program, and the much loved People's President, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
Thank you for the conversation.
Greetings to all of you. When I entered into the beautiful campus of one of the agricultural universities this morning, I realized this land has made India the world's top milk producer. With 139 million tons of wheat production every year. This university has also contributed in introducing BT cotton and groundnut, taking the yield to record high. Just now I have inaugurated the food processing and biofuel college. And this is a Vidya Dairy. Value addition is a key component of wealth generation in the modern economy based on commodities in global system. I am very happy to see their lead being taken in this important area. Friends, in this conversation address, when I see you, all the graduates, in the beautiful Angavastram compared to the British gown. I congratulate the university authorities for introducing as a concrete conversation dress, very simple and Indian dress. I would like to greet Chancellor of the university, Srimati Dr. Kamala, and the Honorable State Minister for Agriculture, Govind Bhai Patel. He gave, Patel ji, gave all of you a beautiful advice, all the graduating students. That advice is, two advices he gave. Advice was, ensure as a graduate of Ananda Agricultural University, every farmer gets quality inputs. Every farmer gets quality inputs. And also ensure the productivity of the farmer, every farmer, farming family increases. Two beautiful advices he gave to all of us. And my friend, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of the University, Dr. A.M.K. and also other university vice chancellor, that is Dr. Genki Patel of Junagadh Agricultural University, and Dr. A. Patek, vice chancellor, Navsar Agricultural University, and Dr. P. R. Vaishnav Registrar, all the faculty members, all the students, the graduating students, and the last-year students, all of you, my greetings to all of you. Friends, I have come to Anand many times to meet my friend Dr. Varghese Kurian. He lived more than 5 decades and Dr. Kurian organized the Farmers Care Fusion White Revolution, today India's world largest meat producer. Of course, the University of Oxford. Friends, in this gathering of agriculture scientists and students, I want to share a thought. We all here bless children of Mother Earth. Whose blessing? Say this carefully. Whose blessing? Mother Earth blessing. Of 6 inches of subsoil or 150 millimeter depth, 6 inches of subsoil and rain grow all the food that people living in this planet need. Last night, every one of you graduates here, you must read this book. Last night I was reading a recently published book. What a wonderful world. Name of the book, What a Wonderful World, written by Marcus Chow. I want to quote a beautiful paragraph from the book that captures well the importance of agriculture to sustain human life on our planet. Marcus Chow writes in his book, quote, "Let us remember why we are here. Because our farming ancestors learned the fine art of growing crops from the wild plants, and agriculture was the source. Man, despite his artistic pretensions, his sophistication, and his many accomplishments, owes his existence to a 6-inch layer of the topsoil and the fact we get rain. The top soil of 6 inches that make all the miracles. India is producing 250 million tons of food. It's all because of top soil of 6 inches and the rain. Friends, indeed, I am delighted to participate in the 10th annual convocation of Anand Agriculture University. My greeting to Honorable Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, and other universities, members of the Board of Management and Academic Council, deans of various faculties, distinguished guests, and dear students. I take this opportunity to pay the rich tribute to this great land of Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Shri K. Munshiji, and many such luminaries. Today, when a graduate got a 11 medals, and all of you graduating today, I will know one day you will become the great leader in thinking, leader in political system, leader in science, leader in technology, leader in agriculture. I am also happy to inaugurate the 2 faculties of AAU today, that is Building for Fermented Products Project of Vidya Dairy and SMC College of Dairy Sciences to impart hands-on training to the students for manufacture of fermented dairy products. The other one is Building of a College of Food Processing Technology and Bioenergy, which I am being related to the bioenergy, but The topic I have selected for the conversation today is dimension of 21st century Indian agriculture. The topic is dimensions of 21st century of Indian agriculture. Even though I have got 16 pages of lecture, I am not going to do that. Okay, but definitely I am going to important points I would like to convey to you. First, I would like to ask myself, what is AU's contribution on the agriculture industry contribution? Gujarat is an important agriculture state where several major crops such as rice, wheat, maize, groundnut, castor, cotton, and tobacco are grown. Animal husbandry and dairy has played a vital role in rural economy of Gujarat. The state is also leading producer of marine fisheries in the country. Since the last few years, the agricultural growth of Gujarat is phenomenal. And I believe the major contribution must be from SAU Gujarat besides the enterprising farmers of the state. India has made tremendous progress in agriculture after independence. Our achievement in bringing green revolution, yellow revolution, white revolution, and blue revolution are notable. Agriculture and livelihoods are intimately linked in our country. Mixed farming involving crop, livestock, and sometimes fish integration has been both way of life and a means of sustainable livelihood. Universities have played a major role in generating quality human resource and will continue to do so to address the challenges ahead. But land suitability evolution is a process of determining the potential of the land for alternative uses and farms' prerequisite for land use planning, which integrates soil characteristics with eliminates and with the climate and land use. Soil conservation measures like land leveling, contour bending, terracing increase the water use of efficiency by providing favorable conditions for marginal utilization of the crops. Our Minister of Agriculture, he was addressing the graduates on organic farming. Organic agriculture is a new emerging opportunity to develop a market for Indian agro products get better value. If you want to know value addition to do, you have to do it in the organic farming. Demand for biocarton, chemical free food grains, species, fruits and vegetables is a growing need for some domestic and also overseas markets. The main issue is to investigate our technology transfer services and provide a complete support services to each farmer. Every farmer has to be treated as a business unit. The extension center has to be treated as a business unit. The extension center has to be the his guide and problem shooter for next room stability. Today, one of the major problems in the field of agriculture is small size land holdings by farmers, which is continuously getting fragmented due to our family structure. Under these circumstances, the only solution for increasing the productivity is to create a positive farmer cooperative movement in our rural sector, which will bring together small farmers facilitating a mechanized farm. A silo storage, value addition, and marketing of agro products. Fortunately, the state where you live, Gujarat, has a tremendous experience cooperative movement in production of milk products. When the farmer's production increases, these cooperatives will forecast and establish networks with markets on behalf of the individual farmer members to facilitate basic movement wherever there is a demand and profit. Also, the entrepreneurs should plan for diversification and value addition of the product needed by various sections of the society. Now, friends, I don't know how much you are taught on transgenic technology. The transgenic technology is a very important field. This year marks the 30th anniversary of first successful introduction of a foreign gene into a plant. A transgenic crop plant contains a gene or genes which have been artificially inserted instead of the plant acquiring them through pollination. Depending on where and for what purpose the plant is grown, desirable genes may provide features such as high yield or improved quality, pest or disease resistant or tolerant to the heat, cold and drought. Transgenic technology enables plant breeders to bring together in one plant useful gene for a wide range of living sources, not just or within the crop species or from closely related plants, and expand the possibilities beyond the limitations imposed by the traditional cross-pollination and selection techniques. Transgenic BT corn, for example, which produces its own insecticide, contains a gene from a bacteria. Now I am going to talk about GM technology. In developed countries, the new life science companies have dominated the application of GM technology in agriculture. And we are producing now 2 to 3 million tons of food. In another decade's time, our requirement will be 500 million tons of food because the population purchasing capacity and population increase. There is a clear evidence that the use of GM crops have resulted in significant benefits like higher crop yields, reduced farm costs, increased farm profits and improved health and welfare. And yet there has been heated debate in India over genetically modified GM crops, and the argument has not yet settled. The debate features not only science but also economics mixed with politics, and even religion is taking place almost everywhere. Science cannot be bogged down by dogma, and no illusory fears can stop the advancement of what is rational and logical. That is indeed science. That is indeed admissible to science. The solution lies in developing beneficial transgenic crops locally. Now, my important point is that International Crop Research Institute for the Semi-Arid Tropics, ADITA, in Hyderabad, and Department of Biotechnology, DPT, Government of India, have together established a platform for translational research on transgenic crops, PTGC, according. The DPT funded platform is a $6.2 billion project that will translate transgenic technology and harness its products to meet the needs of agriculture growth and serve as a facility of reference to strengthen the national, regional and international engagers in transgenic R&D, exchange of material and information, as well as the support training, consultation, technology commercialization. The PTGC, the plan which has been established, will provide an opportunity for public sector research institutes and private sector biotechnology companies to work together for translating transgenic research into products. Now, friends, my favorite area now I'm going to talk to you, that when I visited your laboratory, I talked about it. That is second generation of GM crops. The platform for strategic research and strategic crops, CPC, which has been established at Hyderabad, I inaugurated, will be the birthplace of new generation of strategic crops, which will even surmount the genetically modified crops developed so far in terms of their ability to lower farm level production costs and also feature increased nutritional and the industrial trade, giving direct benefits to affordability and health to the consumer. In his book, The Feeding the Forgotten Poor, Dr. William Dow, Director General of ASAP, has drawn the map for the second generation GM crops. It is not hard to imagine the immense value of rice enriched with iron. I will repeat it. It is not hard to imagine the immense value of rice enriched with iron, vitamin A and E, and icing, potatoes with higher starch content, and insulin, edible vaccines in mice, banana and potatoes. Mice varieties with low physic and increased essential amino acids, healthier oils for soya beans and canola and allergen free nuts. I have no doubt that the developing world like us stands to benefit from many technologies that can increase food production, lower food prices and improve food quality. Nutritionally, enriched food could play a key role in helping to alleviate malnutrition for developing countries. I am sure the young graduates today, all who graduated today, I am sure the young graduates and also students upstairs who will become graduates will contribute to our society by following these basic truths of life. Make a difference. In life, you have to make a difference. Wherever you are, whatever you do, the knowledge and skills that you acquire are not limited. They are probably sufficient to earn a living. But instead of learning to earn, you must try to earn for learning. Understand that ultimately you will shine as a leader if you possess an attitude of good human being. A human being who tries to live among fellow human beings for betterment of all human beings, who tries to give back much more to the society than what has received from it. Now friends, I might say that I thought of the essential thing I want to say. You know, whenever I discuss the agriculture forum, one question comes in. Question is, Gujarat agriculture growth rate is 9%, minimum 9%, 9-10%, sometimes 8-10%. I was asking myself, I asked the IAF professors in Ahmedabad, I asked many experts in this Gujarat, tell me how when the average natural average is 4% growth rate in agriculture, 3-4%, how to achieve? On October 12, 2009, when I was in the middle of academic session, as a part of a course, Greek 2 at IIM Ahmedabad, I teach here at IIM Ahmedabad. There was a call from the Center of Management in Agriculture. They would like to have a session with me. I agreed and met CMAT, comprised of Dean of Professors, Faculty, and Research Scholars at IIM Ahmedabad. So CMAT said, Dean Professor Sukhpal Singh, Dr. Ravinder Tolakia, and others were participating. After my talk, I asked one question to a CMAT team. Can you please explain when the entire India has achieved about 3 to 4% growth rate in agriculture production, how Gujarat is able to attain minimum 7 to 9% growth rate? In a simple way, the entire CMIT explains the growth story, which is an eye opener for the entire nation. When you agriculture graduate, when you are spread throughout the country, all of you, after the degree, remember you have to convey the message, proper message, scientifically. The typical solution for Gujarat based on the scientists and management experts, this is achieved by the mission mode action by the government. Gujarat government has determined not to give free power to farmers. Instead, ensure three-phase electrical supply to agriculture on 24/7 basis. By reorganizing the power distribution channel with the latest state-of-the-art gadget installed and segregating the power distribution between domestic consumption and agriculture consumption. This is the first report. This single action is creating a vigilant force with ex-servicemen to track the power theft and filtrate has resulted in a reduced power theft and increased availability of power to farmers. Micro irrigation facilities were established on a wider scale across the state in a mission which brought 20,000 hectares under the micro irrigation. Due to the construction of a check dam, even this area that gave perennial water scarcity had been an increase in the water stable by 3 to 12 meters. Within a period of 3 years alone, over 75,000 structures were created. 4 centers of excellence had been created with agriculture. An integrated development plan with the employment generation as the focus, given by the provision of the habitat, healthcare, education, skill development, physical and electronic connectivity, and marketing as a business proposition in a sustainable manner with a user. Now, friends, I will say that in the many areas, there are a number of R&D work, but I would like to conclude with you. The second green revolution is indeed the knowledge graduation from characterization of the soil to the matching of the seed with composition of the fertilizer, water management, and evolving pre-harvesting techniques for such conditions. The domain of farmers' work would enlarge from the grain production to storage and marketing also. So, while doing so, the domain of farmers' work would enlarge from the grain production to the food processing and marketing through cooperatives. While doing so, utmost care would be taken for various environment and people-related aspects leading to sustainable development. My best wishes to all the graduating students and also the students who are going to be graduating and the members of the faculty of Honorable British University for success in their mission of working towards enhancement of a sustained agriculture activity. May God bless you all.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a matter of pride and honor to have among us Her Excellency the Governor of Gujarat and Chancellor AU, Dr. Srimati Kamala. Vigilance in watching opportunity, tact and daring in seizing upon opportunity, persistence in crowding opportunity to its utmost of possible achievement. These are the martial values of our Honorable Governor.
I request Her Excellency the Governor of Gujarat and the Chancellor of the University to deliver the presidential address.
Thank you.
भारत के सम्माननीय पूर्व राष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम जी, आदरणीय श्री गोविंद भाई पटेल जी, कृषि राज्य मंत्री गुजरात सरकार, आदरणीय डॉक्टर AM शेख जी कुलपति आनंद कृषि विश्वविद्यालय, आदरणीय डॉक्टर PR वैष्णव जी कुल सचिव महोदय, उपस्थित सभी महानुभाव नियामक मंडल तथा विद्या परिषद के सदस्यगण, विभिन्न विद्या शाखाओं के अधिष्ठातागण, प्राध्यापक, वैज्ञानिकों, अभिभावकों, छात्र एवं छात्राएं, आनंद कृषि विश्वविद्यालय के 10वें दीक्षांत समारोह में आज मुझे यहाँ चौथी बार उपस्थित होने का मौका मिला है। साथ ही हम सबके लिए एक बहुत ही खुशी की अवसर है कि आज हमारे बीच विश्व की विख्यात हस्तियों में से एक प्रखर विद्वान, प्रखर भौतिक वैज्ञानिक, सम्माननीय पूर्व राष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम साहब उपस्थित हैं। आप सभी भाग्यशाली हैं, डॉक्टर कलाम साहब के प्रेरणादायक वचन सुनने का आपको अवसर मिला है। इस विश्वविद्यालय के कुलाधिपति होने के नाते मैं डॉक्टर कलाम साहब का आभार व्यक्त करती हूँ कि आज यहाँ पर उन्होंने सभी को प्रोत्साहित किया। आज के दीक्षांत समारोह में सभी छात्रों और छात्राओं को बहुत बहुत बधाई देती हूँ जिन्होंने अथक मेहनत से उपाधि और पदक हासिल किए हैं। साथ ही मैं प्राध्यापकों और अधिष्ठातागण को भी धन्यवाद देती हूँ कि वह अपने ज्ञान और अनुभव से छात्रों के भविष्य को एक नया आयाम प्रदान किया है। इस विश्वविद्यालय ने शिक्षा, अनुसंधान और कृषि विकास के क्षेत्र में अनेक उपलब्धियां हासिल की हैं। यहाँ पर कृषि विज्ञान, पशु विज्ञान एवं पशुपालन, डेयरी विज्ञान, खाद्य प्रसंस्करण तथा जैव ऊर्जा, कृषि अभियांत्रिकी एवं प्रौद्योगिकी, कृषि सूचना प्रौद्योगिकी, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय कृषि व्यवसाय प्रबंधन आदि संकाय में शिक्षा एवं अनुसंधान का बहुत उत्कृष्ट कार्य किया है। विश्वविद्यालय की विभिन्न संकायों में 10 महाविद्यालय तथा 5 पॉलिटेक्निक कार्यरत हैं। इसके अलावा इस वर्ष जम्मू गांव में भी एक नए कृषि महाविद्यालय की स्थापना हुई है। मुझे ये जानकर खुशी है कि यहाँ पर विभिन्न संकायों के स्नातक स्तर के विद्यार्थियों को किसी वस्तु विषय पर महारत हासिल करने के हेतु एक्सपीरियंस लर्निंग कार्यक्रम चलाए जा रहे हैं जिसमें वे एक उद्यमी बन सके और देश के विकास में अहम भूमिका निभा सके। इस कार्य हेतु डेयरी विज्ञान में विद्या देवी की स्थापना की गई है जिसमें प्रतिदिन 1,00,000 लीटर दूध से बनी अन्य वस्तुओं के उत्पादन, उनकी गुणवत्ता, रखरखाव तथा व्यापार के संबंध में प्रशिक्षण दिया जाता है। ये प्रशिक्षण स्नातक आज विभिन्न डेयरियों में अपने सेवाएं प्रदान कर रहे हैं। इसी तरह से कृषि, पशु विज्ञान तथा अन्य संकाय के स्नातकों को फलों के प्रसंस्करण, जैविक नियंत्रण, जैव कीटनाशी तथा विशिष्ट खनिज मिश्रण आदि के उत्पादन में प्रशिक्षण दिया जा रहा है। भविष्य में ऐसी अन्य समाजोपयोगी इकाइयों की संलग्न की जानी चाहिए जिसमें प्रशिक्षित छात्र छात्राएं समाज की जरूरतों को पूरा कर सकें तथा अपने जीविकोपार्जन के साथ देश की अर्थव्यवस्था को भी मजबूत बनाने में योगदान दे सके। इस विश्वविद्यालय के विभिन्न संकायों के प्राध्यापकों तथा वैज्ञानिकों ने शिक्षा प्रदान करने के अलावा चावल, मक्का, धान, तिलहन, दलहन, तंबाकू, सब्जियां आदि बागवानी की फसलों, चारा फसलों, पशु संवर्धन एवं पोषण डेयरी उत्पादकों और कृषि अभियंत्रिकी, खाद्य प्रसंस्करण इत्यादि से उत्कृष्ट अनुसंधान भी किए हैं। इस विश्वविद्यालय में स्थित अनुसंधान निदेशालय विभिन्न संकायों में किए जाने वाले खोज कार्यों के संचालन का कार्य भी करता है। निदेशक के अंतर्गत छब्बीस क्षेत्रीय केंद्र शोध केंद्र काम कर रहे हैं, जो क्षेत्रीय लोगों की खेती में जरूरत के अनुसार तकनीकों का विकास कर रहे हैं, जो प्रशंसनीय है। विश्वविद्यालय ने सॉयल हैंड कार्ड, पादप जैव प्रौद्योगिकी, पशु जैव प्रौद्योगिकी, टिश्यू कल्चर, औषधीय एवं सुगंधीय पौधों, पशुओं और पालतू लोगों का जैविक नियंत्रण आदि में बहुत उत्कृष्ट हासिल की है, जिसके लिए वो बधाई के पात्र हैं। मुझे आशा है कि भविष्य में इनमें से विकसित होने वाली तकनीकों से कृषि तथा संलग्न क्षेत्रों को लाभ मिलेगा। इस विश्वविद्यालय के प्लांट बायो टेक्नोलॉजी विभाग ने केसर को यहाँ के वातावरण में रोपण तथा उसमें सुगंध प्रदान करने वाले जनीन को अन्य फसलों में प्रतिस्थापित करके शोध शुरू किया। इसी तरह से बायो पेस्टिसाइड्स, लिक्विड बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स, ट्राइकोडर्मा, ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग, माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट, पेस्टिसाइड्स, रेडिएट आदि क्षेत्रों में उपयोगी शोध की जा रही है, जो बेहतर फसल उत्पादन तथा रसायन विहीन पर्यावरण में अनुकूल कीटों और रोगों के प्रबंधन में मददगार साबित होगा। कृषि व्यवसाय में कुशल मानव बल प्रदान करने हेतु यह इंटरनेशनल एग्री बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट की 5 वर्ष पहले स्थापना की गई थी। इस संस्थान से करीब 150 कृषि व्यवसाय में पारंपरिक निर्यात देश तथा बहुराष्ट्रीय कृषि व्यवसाय संस्थानों पर अपना योगदान दे रहे हैं। साथ ही ये संस्थान कृषि व्यवसाय संस्थानों की मांग के अनुरूप मानव बल प्रदान करने का प्रयास भी कर रहा है, जिसकी मैं सराहना करती हूँ। मुझे बताया गया है कि आनंद कृषि विश्वविद्यालय ने करीब 28 पारितोषिक तथा प्रशंसा पत्र हासिल किए हैं। इन पारितोषिकों में कुलपति महोदय को प्रदत्त लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट अवार्ड, वेटनरी तथा डेयरी कॉलेज को बेस्ट कॉलेज ऑफ द ईयर 2013, इंडिया एजुकेशन एक्सेलेंस अवार्ड, जेपी मॉर्गन सोसाइटी इंडस्ट्री अवार्ड मुख्य हैं। इसके लिए विश्वविद्यालय के कुलपति, प्राध्यापक तथा वैज्ञानिक जिन्होंने पारितोषिक प्राप्त किए हैं, ये सभी बधाई के पात्र हैं। कृषि हमारी अर्थव्यवस्था की एक मुख्य स्रोत है तथा अधिकांश लोग केवल में खेती पर जीवन यापन करते हैं। राष्ट्रपिता महात्मा गांधी गांव को सफेद करने के मकसद से जिसे राम राज्य की परिकल्पना साकार हो सके, इसके लिए हम गांव के सामुदायिक विकास पर ध्यान देना होगा। वह जीवन की मूलभूत सुविधाओं, ग्रामजनों के लिए रोजगार तथा कृषि क्षेत्र के समग्र विकास पर जोर दिया जाना जरूरी है। इससे लोगों का गांव से शहर की ओर जो पलायन हो रहा है उसको रोका जा सके। आज हमारे देश में खाद्यान्न की उचित व्यवस्था है, फिर भी बढ़ती हुई जनसंख्या को ध्यान में रखकर दालों, धान, बागवानी तथा अन्य फसलों के उत्पादन पर पूरा ध्यान देना होगा। किसानों के द्वारा की गई कृषि उपज का उचित मूल्य मिला सके, इसके लिए प्रयास करने होंगे। देश में फलों एवं अन्य कई कृषि उत्पादों को विदेश में निर्यात की प्रचुर संभावनाएं हैं, इस दिशा में उचित कार्य किए जाने की आवश्यकता है। देश के महान सपूत और अखंड भारत के निर्माता लोकपुर सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल की भूमि पर स्थापित इस विश्वविद्यालय के सभी छात्र एवं छात्राएं भाग्यशाली हैं, जो सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल के जीवन से प्रेरणा लेकर अपने विशिष्ट ज्ञान से देश के कृषि विकास में महत्वपूर्णता हासिल करेंगे, ऐसा मुझे पूर्ण विश्वास है। अंत में मैं उपाधि एवं पदक प्राप्त करने वाले सभी छात्रों को बहुत बहुत बधाई देती हूँ और उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आप यहाँ प्राप्त आपके में प्रयास किया गया ये बहुमूल्य ज्ञान देश और समाज के उत्कर्ष में उपयोग करेंगे और राज्य की समृद्धि में अपना योगदान देंगे। आपके मंगल में दुर्गल की कामना करती हूँ। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
Those moments when our hearts are conscious of our treasure. We are rich in experience due to the treasure house of wisdom that have lit up the stage today. As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words but to live by them. I shall now call upon our respected registrar, Dr. P. R. Vaishnav, to deliver the vote of thanks.
On this memorable day, I am at a loss of words to gratefully acknowledge the esteemed presence of Dr. Srimati Kamala, Honorable Governor and the Chancellor of this university. I am with us today and presiding over the 10th convocation of AAU. We cannot thank you enough, Madam, for glorifying the occasion and for conferring the degrees and medals to the students and blessing them. With your continuous patronage and guidance, we have been able to take longer stride for academic excellence. With profound sense of gratitude, I must say that it is the good fortunate of AAU to have Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir, former President of India, among us today. Sir, your superlative profile and your magnificent presence here today have surely inspired our young graduates to take cue from you. On behalf of all of us, I heartily thank you for the convocation address. I express my deep gratitude to the guest of honor and honorable Minister of State for Agriculture, Sri Govindbhai sir. It is our great fortune to have here today as a person that man of affairs of the state, which has taken a lead to the next agriculture revolution in the country. I profusely thank you, sir, for being our driving force and a pillar of strength. What failed me to thank you, our honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. A.M. Sheikh sir, for his profound vision and dynamic leadership in making AAU emerge as a frontrunner not only among the agriculture institutes of state but also at the national level. I express my deep gratitude to all the members of Board of Management and Academic Council for providing the right direction, support and encouragement. I profoundly thank Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. N.C. Patel sir, Dr. A.R. Bhadak sir, for NAU and JAU respectively, other dignitaries and innovators for their august presence, which has multiplied the grace of the occasion. I thank all the directors, deans and faculties of the officers, principals, HOD and other AAU families for their active participation and immense cooperation in this memorable event. My profound thanks to Sri Rahul B. Gupta sir, district collector Anand, for sparing his valuable time and sharing an academic platform with us. My thanks are due to Sri R.V. Asari, DSP sir Anand, for his entire team for providing the much needed security arrangement in organizing this event. I gratefully acknowledge and heartily thank you all the media persons present here today for prominently highlighting the activities of our university from time to time. I also express my sincere thanks to all the donors and medals and contributing agencies. I thank the entire staff of Register Office and the members of various committees for rendering their services, particularly in the adverse climatic situation throughout the preparation of this occasion, and all those who have directly or indirectly contributed for making this a memorable trip. Finally, I will be failing in my duty if I do not congratulate the recipients of the medals and degrees on this day. Dear recipients, as a progeny of AAU, you have made your alma mater proud by your brilliance and hard work in achieving academic excellence. Thank you, one and all. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. Now we shall all rise for the national anthem by the police band, and after that shall remain standing until the dignitaries leave the dais. one and all. Kindly remain seated till the dignitaries leave the auditorium. All are requested to kindly be seated till the dignitaries leave the auditorium. Students, kindly take their seats.